It's only a game. Why you have to be mad?
What is up, Heroes of Dominion? My name is Charlie. This is Hero Wars Central, and today we have a special guest. We've got Bob from the community manager team, the browser community manager team. Well, this doesn't really work. The next question doesn't really work then. I was going to ask you if your favorite hero was Kark, but who is your favorite hero then?
No, it's not Kark, really. You know, when it comes to visual design, I always loved Martha, and I absolutely loved the summer skin that we got her, because that was an idea that was circling in the community both and inside our community manager's circle. So when it actually happened, when developers decided to actually implement that skin, that was absolutely insanely good. And but you know, when it comes to like gameplay wise, I love Kira. Like Kira is definitely my most favorite hero, because each time I play an RPG, all those armor mechanics, they really bore me. I like to do a lot of damage, and Kira does exactly that. She pierces the armor. I like the armor piercing mechanics in the games. So yeah, that's why it's Kira, definitely.
So you have Kira. Is Kira your main team, your main pack that
yes,
you use?
Yes, it is.
Are you more of like the blender, really fast, no healer variety, or are you more of like a controller with like Astaroth as a tank?
I do have Astaroth as a tank, Martha. So the whole composition goes like this. I have Astaroth, I have Kira, I have Martha, I have Sebastian, who's obviously really good. And I have a pretty unconventional Jin Mao or King Mao. I'm not really sure how to pronounce that yet. The reason I picked her even before the whole evasion rework thing, when Kira started to gain energy while evading attacks. I picked her even before that, when I wasn't really all that well-versed in the game, but then I realized that it's still a pretty good combination since Jin Mao kind of decreases enemy's armor, and which makes it easier for Kira to pierce tank's armor and go through an entire team.
Sure.
So I really like her, and after she started gaining energy while dodging, she became even better, and I absolutely love her Masquerade skin, the latest we had, which is like this pajama cat thing with a spear with a fish on it. I just absolutely love that. So that's why I use her still.
Yeah, one of my favorite things about that skin is her ability that gets modified. Visual of the video, the visual of the ability, I should say.
True. Yeah. That's like this very, very cute cat.
Yeah. Okay, so what pet do you use with that team? It's leading somewhere.
Yeah, sure. Okay. Yeah, I do use Fenris. And when I just started to, get this pack together, I've been thinking about Albus, but then I realized that I won't be able to use Albus to full potential for quite some time, because he gets really good once you get this purple ability for him. Mm-hmm. And, but while you're getting there, you have this long road of while you're upgrading Kira and just your entire team, and it just doesn't allow to, to utilize Albus all that. Albus all that great. Well, Fenris, in my opinion, starts to get better sooner.
Okay.
So that's why I picked him. And I also liked Fenris because he blinded Kark teams, which was very useful to me.
The reason why I asked that is because a large majority of the questions that my community wanted me to ask you had to do with pets and adventures, and so I'd like to talk about that a little bit, if you don't mind.
Of course.
Will there be pets added in the future?
Yeah. So I actually really like that you started off with that topic, because I believe the most juicy part is about adventures. Mm-hmm. And about what we're gonna talk about. So first of all, yes, new pet is coming, and it's actually coming real soon.
Ooh.
So it's not even a matter of a distant future. I'm not gonna call out an actual date, but you can expect a new pet added to the game real soon.
Ah, you guys hear that? That's exciting.
Yeah,
I'll have to do another pet video.
True. And it's gonna come. This pet is going to come with actually quite a number of changes, quality of life changes mostly to adventures.
Mm.
Now, okay. Alongside with that pet, we're gonna have obviously an event revolving around that new pet, and not only that, but we will add a pretty interesting feature even a couple of features to the game when it comes to adventures. First of all, I will start from a smaller one, then I'll get to the, you know, to the bigger part of it.
Okay.
It's pretty exciting. So we do have this, you know, a merchant that is opened only when you get an absolute star pet.
Sure. Sure.
And this merchant sells pet potions, it sells chaos particles, and it also sells different types of hero soul stones. What we're going to do is we're going to remove the requirement of having an absolute star pet to have this merchant available.
Wow.
So you'll actually be able to access this merchant even if you don't have an absolute star pet. So that's for starters.
That's a huge quality of life improvement.
I do think so too. It's pretty cool because I've been playing like every day starting February of this year. I've been very active on one of our Russian versions, and I still didn't really get to the point of having an absolute star pet. So even to me, like to me, it's very exciting when I realized it's going to happen, because I could really use some pet potions, you know, some chaos particles and stuff like that.
Yeah, chaos now, particles is the big one.
Actually, now that I think of it, I'm not really sure about the changes of the content of that shop, because you know, right now you can only buy things in that shop using the pet coins that you get only after you get, you know, an absolute star pet. Mm-hmm. So I'm not really sure how that's going to change. We'll have to wait and see.
Yeah.
So that's that. But that's not the only thing that's evading us in adventures. We are actually adding a raid function to the adventures. But this function is not going to work entirely the same way you have the raids in, like, say, you know, campaign, right? So the way they're going to work is the following. For example, you log in and you complete the 6th adventure, right? And now that when you complete it, you can raid that adventure for the duration of the current day, naturally for the amount of portal charges that you have. So for example, you finish the 6th adventure, right?
Right.
And you have 5 portal charges left. And if you don't want to, you know, spend them in any other way, you can just raid this 6th adventure for the duration of the current day and get the, all the rewards you would otherwise get. So that will help, you know, that will help out in the situations when you might have not logged in more than like 5 days. So you don't want those portal charges to just hit the maximum amount and not accumulate. So I think it's a pretty good way to spend those.
So can you repeat that again? Will those raids require 3 people?
Actually, I'm not really sure about that, but I'm really afraid to say,
of course,
the wrong thing here, because we didn't really go into details with developers about that particular part.
Yeah.
So I don't want to speculate on that. I'm not really sure if you need other 3 people, but I would suggest, and I might be wrong on that, that since it's a raid, right, that basically a press of a button, then you don't really need 3 other people. That's what I assume.
That's also a huge quality of life improvement, because I can't tell you how many times, like especially with this quiz event, it seemed like on the last day of the event, it was a rush to get people to finish because you needed to complete 7 or you needed to start 7 adventures.
Start. Yeah, you didn't need to finish them, but since you started them, right, you kind of want the value.
Right. Right. You didn't want to just rush through it, you know, start and leave. And with portal charges being as rare as they are.
Yeah.
Wow. That's pretty amazing.
That's it. And that is not even it about adventures, by the way. So we have a couple of other pretty good quality of life changes, not as huge, but still. So first of all, the overall amount of drop in adventures is going to be increased. So everything that drops right now, like pet potions, chaos particles, everything is going to be increased. And for example, also we have like the top, you know, the top stones for pets that can only be, won in the last adventure.
Yeah.
They can't be purchased for chaos particles like all the previous ones. That requirement will be gone too. You will be able to just purchase them with chaos particles as well.
Okay.
And the overall difficulty of the latest adventures is going to be lowered a bit to increase the accessibility to a bigger amount of players who actually want to participate in the, you know, the ultimate late game that we have right now.
Right. How about max testing with pets?
Mm-hmm.
Is that in the future?
Sure. So here's what our developers had to say about that. First of all, both us players and developers think that that's a good idea to have pets in the testing modes, like the one the in the test battles that you can run in guild chat, right?
Right. Right.
The thing is, this will require pretty significant rework of how the patronage works right now, because I know that from a standpoint of view, you might think, well, let's just add just this specific window, maybe a button to add a patron.
It's never that easy.
Hero, it's never that easy, and it will require a pretty significant rework of this feature in general. So instead of just adding that, we will wait until we have time and resources to not only address patronage in testing battles, but also to address patronage, different modes. When we'll have time, we'll just make it so patronage is unique for each game mode that you would like to. For example, you have this patronage for Guild Wars, you have this patronage for Arena, you have this patronage for Grand Arena. And alongside with that, we want to add max testing with pets. So that's, and only that's when it would happen. But obviously, we don't really have an estimate for it. Many things are coming. For example, as you know, Halloween is coming, and we'll definitely talk about that. We will have lots of content to release, including the new pet, including the new adventure, including all the things that I've just talked
new adventure
through. No, sorry, did I say new adventure? I said new stuff in adventures, like new pet, new events surrounding the pet, and all those quality of life changes that I talked about adventures.
Okay.
But
that's fair.
We're not having a new adventure map soon.
That was another question that we got quite a bit. And then kind of the last thing to wrap up the whole pet and adventure discussion, when will we see pet focused or I should say events that are focused on pet rewards? Like, we've got an artifact event happening right now. We have a lot of events that are on rotation. In fact, in the last 3 to 6 months, some new events have been added to the monthly rotation, which some of them are very strongly free to play, as they say, which I'm very excited about having more events that are catering to those types of players. But will we see events where the main rewards are portal charges and you know, the all those resources that we never seem to have enough of?
Chaos particles, right? Maybe pet potions, maybe equipment. Yeah, I see. So here's the thing. As far as I know, the closest pet event is obviously going to start with the new pet added, which is going to happen soon. But I can't really talk about the content of that event.
Okay.
But it's probably not going to be that event that people mean when they say a pet event, right? Because I think when people say pet event, they mean an event that would suit any type of pet they could have, right? It would it would have to have like chaos particles as a reward, portal charges, maybe some summoning eggs,
right?
From which you get their soul stones. That type of event is probably not the one that we are going to have with the new pet. So again, I'm not really sure when this type of event is going to happen.
Okay.
Because right now we have this huge thing about adventures that we want to, you know, that we want to see the light of day. And after we're done with that, I will definitely, like, that's what we do. We know that this event is very, like, you know, asked in our community. So what we as community managers do, we ask our developers all the time about, when is an estimate of when you can start considering it or working on it. And it's not yet the time, unfortunately.
So. Okay.